Assalamu alaikum friends. Welcome to this MATLAB tutorial. Today I am going to teach you how to perform load flow analysis of IEEE 9 bus system using MATPOWER toolbox. In this video tutorial, I will teach you how to apply, perform and compare all three load flow methods such as Newton-Raphson method, Gauss-Seidel method and fast decoupled method on IEEE 9 bus system using MATPOWER toolbox. For this purpose, you must have installed the MATPOWER toolbox in MATLAB software. This MATPOWER toolbox is freely available. For your convenience, I have already made the video on this topic with the title on how to download and install MATPOWER toolbox in MATLAB software. Therefore, I would like to strongly suggest you to watch this video first in order to understand this tutorial. Now come to MATLAB screen. First, bring this MATPOWER toolbox folder from any drive where you have saved it in the current section folder as shown here. You can see MATPOWER folder is available here. Double click on this MATPOWER folder to open it. You can see it shows all the subfolders of MATPOWER toolbox. Friends, MATPOWER is extremely useful toolbox for power system engineers to do their research. This toolbox provides 59 built-in MATLAB program of various famous test systems. All these MATLAB programs of various test systems are shown in the data folder of the MATPOWER toolbox. You can directly use these programs by double-clicking on it. Consider the table which provides the list of all the standard transmission test systems. You can see it includes the MATLAB programs of various standard test systems including the IEEE 9 bus system, IEEE 14 bus system, IEEE 30 bus system, IEEE 57 bus system, IEEE 118 bus system, and IEEE 300 bus system. Similarly, look at another table which provides the list of all the standard radial distribution test system. You can see it includes MATLAB programs of various standard test system including the famous IEEE 33 and IEEE 69 bus system. Similarly, look at these tables which provides the list and MATLAB programs of all standard synthetic grid test systems, Polish test systems, European test systems and French test system respectively. From these tables, you can realize how this MATPOWER toolbox is useful for the electrical power engineers to do their research. Let me show you all these MATLAB programs of all the standard test system by double-clicking on this data folder of the MATPOWER toolbox. You can see here all the MATLAB programs of various standard test systems are available. It means that MATLAB programs of all these test systems are already written. We have to use the load flow command only to perform the load flow analysis of any system. Let's learn how to open the IEEE 9 bus MATLAB program and perform its load flow analysis using all three methods. In the first step, we should know how to load any particular case in MATLAB in order to see its data. Look at the syntax to load any case. You can see the syntax consists of three acronyms. First is MPC, which stands for MATPOWER case. Second is load case, which is the MATLAB power command, and third is the case file name, which represents the name of the particular case. Therefore, if we want to load IEEE 9 bus system case, then we should know the name of the IEEE 9 bus system MATLAB program. It can be noticed from the table that MATLAB program name for IEEE 9 bus system is case 9. Therefore, to load IEEE 9 bus system MATLAB program, the syntax becomes as shown here. Now copy this command, come to MATLAB screen and paste it here. You can see it has provided the structure file of the IEEE 9 bus system as shown here. Double click on it to see its various data variables. You can see it provides the data of the base MVA, bus data, generator data, branch or line data, as well as generator cost data of IEEE 9 bus system. Double click on the bus data to see its values. You can see it provides all the details of the IEEE 9 bus data. For better understanding, let's see its MATLAB program. You can see MATLAB program of IEEE 9 bus system is available here. Double click on it to open it. You can see this MATLAB program provides all the details of IEEE 9 bus system. This section provides the reference from where this data is taken. If you want to learn the basic details of this program and its variables, then you may see the case format M file. This case format M file will be available in the library folder of this MATPower. For this purpose, go to library folder and double click on it to open it, as shown here. You can see case format file is available here. Double click on it to open it. It provides the details of each row as well as column entry of the bus data, generator data, branch data, as well as generator cost data of any test system. Let's check the IEEE 9 bus test system data. Look at the figure which shows the single line diagram of IEEE 9 bus system. This test system consists of 3 generators as well as 3 loads. Now look at the table which shows the bus data of IEEE 9 bus system. It may be noted that MATPower has assigned the code 1 for the load bus, 2 for the PV bus, and 3 for select bus. As bus 1 is considered as select bus, therefore bus code 3 is written here. Similarly, bus 2 and 3 are considered as PV buses, therefore bus code 2 is written here. Rest of the buses are load buses, therefore bus code 1 is written here. Now come to MATLAB program again and check the bus number and bus code information. You can see both are correct. Look at the table again. It may be noted that loads are connected on bus 5, 6 and 8 respectively with their magnitudes as shown here. Now come to MATLAB program again and check the load magnitudes with their bus numbers. You can see load magnitudes are correct, however they are placed at some other buses. It may be noted that data used in this program is correct. However, it has not inserted some of the data at their correct bus number. You may use this data as it is. The results will also be correct, but some of the results may be interchanged with other buses. Later on, I will show you the correct MATLAB program, which I have made by rearranging the data in the correct order. Friends, leave the other entries as it is. It is because MATPower toolbox uses the same program for many purposes, such as this same program can be used for optimal power flow, economic load dispatch, unit decommitment, and continuation power flow, etc. Thus, this program contains all the necessary data in order to use it for all the tasks. Therefore, keep the other data as it is. Similarly, look at the table again. The bus voltages for all the buses are shown here. Therefore, come to MATLAB program again and check the voltages of all the buses. You can see all the bus voltages are correct. Similarly, look at the table again. The real and reactive power magnitudes for PV buses are shown here. Now come to MATLAB program again and check the power magnitudes of PV buses. You can see all the power magnitudes are almost correct with slight difference in their values. Furthermore, it also contains the power magnitudes of select bus 2. However, it may be noted that this magnitude is inserted as random value. The actual value will be known after the completion of load flow solution. Similarly, look at the table again. The line data with their resistance, reactance, and susceptance values are shown here. Now come to MATLAB program again and check the line or branch data of all the lines. You can see all the values are correct. However, their values are interchanged with other bus lines. You may use this data as it is. Friends, leave the other data as it is. Let's learn how to perform the load flow analysis. The syntax to run the load flow analysis of any particular system is shown here, where run PF means run power flow, which is a MATLAB function. In the brackets, name of the MATLAB program is written. Therefore, for IEEE 9 bus system, the syntax as well as command will become as shown here. It may be noted that by default, this program performs the load flow analysis using Newton-Raphson method. Therefore, copy this command, come to MATLAB screen and paste it here. You can see it has successfully performed the load flow analysis of IEEE 9 bus system using the Newton-Raphson method as shown here. It has taken 4 iterations to complete the solution and has taken the computational time of 0.5 seconds. It further shows the important results of IEEE 9 bus system, such as minimum and maximum voltage magnitudes, angles, active and reactive power loss. It further shows the bus voltage magnitudes as well as angles of all the buses as shown here. Now compare the results with the load flow solution results of IEEE 9 bus system. You can see all the results are correct. However, they are interchanged with some other bus results. Similarly, compare the power flow results with the load flow solution results of IEEE 9 bus system. You can see all the results are correct. However, they are again interchanged with some other bus results. Friends, if you want to use this program, it is also good. It is because it provides all the results correct. However, the results are interchanged with other buses due to the reason that data was placed wrongly at some other buses. However, to get the accurate results, I have again rearranged the whole data and inserted them in the correct order. I have saved this file with the name as shown here. Double click on it to open this program. Now you can check the whole data with the actual data. You can see all the data is placed correctly. Friends, for your convenience, I have shared this correct MATLAB program of IEEE 9 bus system as well as its PDF in the form of link in the description section of this video. You can download it from there. Let's perform the load flow analysis of this correct program. For this purpose, come to MATLAB screen. Use the command as shown here. You can see it has successfully performed the load flow analysis of IEEE 9 bus system using the Newton-Raphson method as shown here. It has taken 4 iterations to complete the solution and has taken the computational time of 0.04 seconds. Now compare all the results with the load flow solution results of IEEE 9 bus system. You can see all the results are correct. Now let's perform the load flow analysis using the Gauss-Seidel method. The syntax to change the load flow method is shown here. Look at the table, it shows the made power names for various load flow methods. As we are going to perform load flow analysis using Gauss Seidel method, therefore the term GS can be written in the syntax as shown here. Now copy this command, come to MATLAB screen and paste it here. You can see it has successfully performed the load flow analysis of IEEE 9 bus system using Gauss Seidel method as shown here. It has taken 211 iterations to complete the solution and has taken the computational time of 0.16 seconds. Now compare all the results with the load flow solution results of IEEE 9 bus system. You can see all the results are correct. Let's perform the load flow analysis using the fast decoupled method. As we are going to perform load flow analysis using fast decoupled method which has two versions. Therefore, let's use the term FDBX in the syntax as shown here. Copy this command, come to MATLAB screen and paste it here. You can see it has successfully performed the load flow analysis of IEEE 9 bus system using fast decoupled method in BX version as shown here. It has taken 6 iterations to complete the solution and has taken the computational time of 0.33 seconds. Now compare all the results with the load flow solution results of IEEE 9 bus system. You can see all the results are correct. Let's also perform the load flow analysis using fast decoupled method in XB version. For this purpose, use the term FDXB in the syntax as shown here. Now copy this command, come to MATLAB screen and paste it here. You can see it has successfully performed the load flow analysis of IEEE 9 bus system using fast decoupled method in XB version as shown here. It has taken 6 iterations to complete the solution and has taken the computational time of 0.07 seconds. Now compare all the results with the load flow solution results of IEEE 9 bus system. You can see all the results are correct. Friends, depending upon the processor of your computer or laptop, your results may vary in terms of computational time. The comparative results of all load flow methods in terms of iterations and computational times are shown here. It may be noted that for IEEE 9 bus system, Newton-Raphson method has superior performance both in terms of iterations as well as computational time. The fast decoupled load flow method is at the second position followed by Gauss Seidel method. Friends, by following the same procedure, the load flow analysis of any system can be carried out in MATPOWER toolbox. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.